Hello friends, welcome to my channel Physics Boy. I am solving JS 2017 physics paper. I will upload all physics questions one by one, and now I am going to discuss all questions from part B JS 2017. So watch this video till the end. Let me start with this question. Let a particle of mass 10⁻⁹ kg constant to move one dimensional motion be initially at the origin x is equal to 0 meter. The particle is in equilibrium with a thermal bath where kt is equal to 10⁻⁸ joule. You have to find the average of x square of the particle after a time t is equal to 5 seconds. You know average of x square can be written as integration minus infinity to infinity x square e to the power beta epsilon I dx divided by minus infinity to infinity e to the power beta epsilon I dx, where beta is equal to 1 by kt and epsilon I is the energy, which is equal to half mv square. If you put energy epsilon I is equal to half mv square in the first line, then you will get the second line. Now in second line, if you put v is equal to x by t, then you will get this line. And now we have to perform these two integration. The integration on the denominator is look like minus infinity to infinity x square e to the power minus alpha x square dx, where alpha is equal to beta m by 2 t square. Now this integration is equal to square root of pi by alpha in times 1 by 2 alpha. So if you put this value, then you will get the second line. Of similarly, the numerator is equal to minus infinity to infinity e to the power minus alpha x square dx, which is equal to square root of pi by alpha. So if you put these two value of integration, then you will get t square by beta m. Now find the value of x square at time t is equal to 5 seconds. So I am putting beta is equal to 1 by kt and kt is equal to 10⁻⁸ joule, and t square, which is equal to 5 square 25, and m, that is the mass of the particle, which is equal to 10⁻⁹. So if you solve this equation, then you will get 250. So the answer is 0250. Next question is, a solid insulating sphere of radius 1 cm has charge 10⁻⁷ coulomb distributed uniformly over its volume. It is surrounded concentrically by a conducting thick spherical shell of inner radius 2 cm and outer radius 2.5 cm and is charged with minus 2 times 10⁻⁷ coulomb. What is the electrostatic potential in volts on the surface of the sphere? Now if you draw the picture, I know it will be better than this picture. Anyway, assume this is a insulating sphere inside a spherical conducting shell. As the spherical shell is conducting, so minus 2 times 10⁻⁷ coulomb charge lies on the outer surface of this conductor. Again, the insulating sphere has charge 10⁻⁷ coulomb, so it will induce minus 10⁻⁷ coulomb charge on the inner surface and plus 10⁻⁷ coulomb charge on the outer surface of the spherical shell respectively. Here I want to point out one mistake. I wrote 10⁻⁷, but it will be minus 10⁻⁷. So please correct this. So potential on the surface can be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught times q1 by r1 plus q2 by r2 plus q3 by r3. Now if you put q1, q2 and q3 and r1, r2 and r3, and by simplifying this you will get 9000. So the correct answer is 9000. If xt be the position operator at a time t in the Heisenberg picture for a particle described by the Hamiltonian h cap is equal to this, then you have to find what is the value of this quantity in units of h cut by 2m omega, where k0 is the ground state. You know in Heisenberg picture position operator x at time t can be written as x cap t is equal to exponential I h t by h cut times x cap 0 times exponential minus I h t by h. Now we can write exponential I omega t bra 0 position operator x at time t times the position operator x at time 0 ket 0. For harmonic oscillator x 0 can be written in terms of annihilation and creation operator as x 0 is equal to square root of h cut by 2m omega times a plus a dagger. Now inserting x into this equation and operating a and a dagger on 0 state, we get exponential I omega t times bra 0 position operator x at time t ket 1 times square root of h by 2 omega m. Now inserting x at time t into this equation, we get this. This equation can be written in integration form instead of bracket algebra like this. You see that here I have already put the value of energy corresponding to the ground state and fast excited state of the harmonic oscillator. And you know ground state eigenvalue of harmonic oscillator is h cut omega by 2 and energy eigenvalue corresponding to fast excited state of harmonic oscillator is 3 h cut omega by 2. So by simplifying this, we get square root of h by 2 m omega times bra 0 x operator at time 0 ket 1. Now again inserting the value of position operator at time t is equal to 0 in terms of annihilation and creation operator, and then simplifying this, we get h cut by 2 m omega. And according to this question, you must have to write the answer in unit of h cut by 2 m omega. So the answer is triple. Next question is, for this circuit, what is the ratio of I1 by I2? At first I am going to find the equivalent resistance of this circuit to find the value of I1. At first let me numbering all loops. It will help me to describe the solutions. Look at the loop 1. 2R is parallel with 2 series resistance of value R. So for this loop, equivalent resistance is 2R parallel with 2R, which is equal to R. So from the extreme left loop, we get equivalent resistance is equal to R. Now this R is in series with another R on the loop 2. So 2R is again parallel with 2R. So again we get equivalent resistance of loop 2 is equal to R. Similarly for third loop, again we get equivalent resistance is equal to R. Again R and R in series gives 2R. Now for extreme right side of the loop, equivalent resistance is R, and you can calculate it in similar process like this. Finally we get this circuit. Now total equivalent resistance of this circuit is 2R parallel with 2R with a series resistance 2R, which gives 3R. So equivalent resistance of the whole circuit is 3R. So current I1 is equal to E by 3R. Now look at this picture. This is only the left portion of the given circuit. Look at loop 1. Now look, I1 current is divided into two parts with equal value I1 by 2. Now look at the extreme left loop, that is loop 1. I2 current is flowing through R, so 2 times I2 current is entering from loop 2 into this loop. Similarly, 4I2 current is entering from loop 3 into loop 2. And finally, 8I2 current is entering from loop 4 into loop 3. So 8I2 is equal to I1 by 2. So I1 by I2 is equal to 16. If you can understand the symmetry of this circuit in the beginning, then no need to find the equivalent resistance of this circuit. Directly you can find the ratio of this circuit from the current. So final answer is 00. A simple pendulum has a bob of mass 1 kg and charge 1 coulomb. It is suspended by a massless string of length 13 meter. The time period of small oscillation of this pendulum is T0, and if an electric field E is equal to 100 x cap volt per meter is applied, the time period becomes T. What is the value of T naught by T whole to the power 4? So for this problem, T naught is equal to 2 pi square root of L by G, and T is equal to 2 pi times square root of L by A prime, where A prime is the resultant acceleration of the bob. To solve this problem, you have to just find the resultant acceleration of the bob. Now let us consider acceleration of the bob along x direction due to the application of field is A, and the force on the bob due to the electric field is equal to QE, and F is equal to MA. So equating these two, we get A, and putting the value of Q, E and M, we get A is equal to 100 meter per second square along the x direction. Now we have to find the resultant acceleration. Here we have two acceleration, one is along y direction which is equal to 10, and another is along x direction which is equal to 100 meter per second square. So if you find the resultant acceleration, it will be A prime, which is equal to square root of 10100. Now T naught by T, which is equal to square root of A prime by G. So by simplifying this, we get, so the final answer is 010. Next question is, a sphere of inner radius 1 cm and outer radius 2 cm centered at origin has a volume charge density rho naught is equal to k by 4 pi r, where k is a non-zero constant and r is the radial distance. A point charge of magnitude 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb is placed at the origin. For what value of k in units of coulomb per meter square, the electric field inside the cell is constant. Let us consider 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb is equal to q is placed at the origin, and consider a spherical Gaussian surface of radius r, where r is greater than 1 and less than 2. Now we have to calculate the total charge enclosed by this Gaussian surface. Let us consider this charge is q enclosed, which is equal to q plus integration 10 to the power minus 2 to r rho naught dv. Now inserting the value of rho naught from the given question and performing this integration, we get q enclosed is equal to q plus k by 2 times r square minus 10 to the power minus 4. Now from the symmetry, we can say magnitude of E is equal to constant. Now from the Gauss's law, we can write integration E ds is equal to 1 by epsilon times q enclosed, and we get the value of q enclosed, which is equal to q plus k by 2 times r square minus 10 to the power minus 4. As E is constant, so integration ds is equal to 4 pi r square, and by simplifying this, we get the value of E in terms of radius r. As the value of electric field inside the cell is constant, so we can write value of E at the inner surface of the cell is equal to E at outer surface of the cell. So from this condition, we get this equation. By simplifying this equation, we get K is equal to 20. So the final answer is 0020. Next question is, the temperature in a rectangular plate bounded by the lines x is equal to 0, y equal to 0, x equal to 3 and y equal to 5 is T is equal to xy square minus x square y plus 100. What is the maximum temperature difference between two points on the plate? As it is a function of two variables x and y, we have to find partial differential with respect to x and y to find the critical point. So del del x of t is equal to y square minus 2xy. At the extremum point, this derivative must be 0. So y square minus 2xy is equal to 0. So we get either y is equal to 0 or y is equal to 2x. Similarly, del del y of t is equal to 2xy minus x square. And again, at the extremum point, this derivative is equal to 0, so 2yx minus x square is equal to 0. So we get either x is equal to 0 or y is equal to x by 2. Y is equal to 2x and y is equal to x by 2 are two lines on which extremum point lie. This is the plate bounded by the four lines. In this region, x and y can take any positive value or zero. That is, the value of x and y cannot be negative on the plate. Now, to find the maxima and minima, we have to find second order derivative of t. Now, second order derivative of t with respect to x is equal to minus 2y, which is less than 0, because y is positive. So, second order derivative of t is less than 0, so this corresponds to the maximum. Similarly, the second order derivative of t is equal to 2x, which is greater than 0, as x is positive. So, second order derivative of t with respect to y is greater than 0, so this corresponds to the minimum. Now see this picture, y is equal to 2x line and y is equal to 5 line are intersecting each other at the edge of the plate. Similarly, the line y is equal to x by 2 and x is equal to 3 line intersecting at the edge of the plate also. These two intersecting points corresponds to the maxima and minima of the function. Now, to find the intersecting point of y is equal to x by 2 and x is equal to 3 line, we have to put x is equal to 3 on the y is equal to x by 2 equation. So we get y is equal to 1.5. Finally, 3, 1.5 point corresponds to the minimum value of the function t. So by putting the value of x and y on the txy equation, we get t at 3, 1.5 is equal to 93.25. This is the minimum value of t. Similarly, we have to find another critical point for y is equal to 5. We get x is equal to y by 2, which is equal to 2.5. So 2.5, 5 point corresponds to the maximum value of t, and by putting the value of x and y, we get maximum value of t is equal to 131.25. So the difference between maximum and minimum temperature will be 38. So final answer is 0, 0. I'm going to discuss isoentropic expansion problem of statistical mechanics from part B, JS 2017. The question was, suppose that the number of microstates available to a system of n particles depends on n and the combined variable u v square, where u is the internal energy and v is the volume of the system. The system initially has volume 2 meter cube and energy 200 joule. It undergoes an isoentropic expansion to volume 4 meter cube. What is the final pressure of the system in SI units? In this problem, it is given that the number of microstates available to this system depends on number of particles n and the combined variable u v square. So we can write the number of microstate omega is equal to some proportional constant times n u v square. And you know, for isoentropic process, S is equal to constant. So change of entropy, that is dS, is equal to 0 for isoentropic process. On the other hand, for thermodynamics, you know dU is equal to TdS minus PdV. For this system, dS is equal to 0, so dU is equal to minus PdV. So P is equal to minus del U del V at constant S. Okay, now you have the relation between entropy S and the total number of microstates, which is look like this, where S is the entropy, S equal to KB times natural logarithm of omega, where KB is the Boltzmann constant. Now, in this relation, S is constant and omega is alpha n u v square. As left hand side of this equation is constant, so right hand side must be constant. So alpha n u v square is equal to constant. Again, alpha is the proportional constant and n is constant for this system. So u v square is equal to some another constant. I will come back to this relation very soon. Before that, let's see what data is given in this problem. Initially, we have u1, that is internal energy, is equal to 200 joule and volume is 2 meter cube, and n is the number of particles, that is constant. As this system undergoes isoentropic expansion and volume of this system increases to 4 meter cube, but number of particle n remains same. Now come back to the previous relation, that is u v square is equal to constant. Let us assume this constant is equal to c. So u1 v1 square is equal to c. Now by putting the value of u1, that is initial internal energy, which is equal to 200, and initial volume, that is equal to 2 meter cube, we get c is equal to 800. So we get the relation between u and v during this isoentropic process, which is u v square is equal to 800. So u can be written as 800 by v square. Now differentiating this with respect to volume, we get minus 1600 divided by v cube. Now pressure can be written as minus del u del v at constant s. So by putting the value of del u del v, we get pressure is equal to 1600 by v cube. So pressure is a function of volume. When volume becomes 4 meter cube, then pressure becomes 1600 divided by 4 cube, which is equal to 1600 divided by 64 equal to 25. For this question, you must be answered by integers of 4 digits in GST exam, so the answer is 0025. The question was, a particle is described by the following Hamiltonian, where the quadratic term can be treated perturbatively if del E0 and del E1 denote the energy correction of the order of lambda to the ground state and first excited state respectively. What is the fraction del E1 by del E0? In this video, I will solve this problem in two different methods. First one is by using a straightforward perturbation theory, and then I will solve this problem by using a short trick. Okay, this is the given Hamiltonian of one dimensional harmonic oscillator with perturbation lambda x to the power 4. You know the ground state wave function of harmonic oscillator is written as psi naught, which is equal to m omega by pi h cut whole to the power 1/4 times e to the power minus m omega x square by 2 h cut, and the wave function of the first excited state of harmonic oscillator is written as psi 1, which is equal to m omega by pi h cut whole to the power 1/4 times square root of 2 m omega by h cut times x times e to the power m omega x square by 2 h cut. Now you have to calculate the ratio of first order energy correction of first excited state and first order energy correction of ground state of simple harmonic oscillator. At first, I am going to find first order energy correction for the ground state from the time independent perturbation theory. First order energy correction of ground state del E0 is equal to k psi 0 lambda x to the power 4 bra psi 0. Now by putting the value of ground state wave function psi 0 here, we get this equation. Now you see that here we have to evaluate this integration. We can use this general formula to perform this type of integration. Here we have x to the power 4 term, so we have to put n is equal to 2 in this general formula, nothing else. Now come back to the energy correction formula after putting the value of this integration. So we end up with the value of del E0 is equal to 3 lambda h cut square by 4 m square omega square. Similarly, we have to find the first order energy correction of the first excited state. Here we have to insert wave function of the first excited state of the harmonic oscillator. As in the previous case, here also we have to evaluate this integration, The only difference is here x to the power 6 term is present instead of x to the power 4 term. So by putting the value of n3 in the general integration formula, as I said earlier, after inserting this value of integration, we end up with the value of del e1, which is equal to 15 lambda h cut square by 4 m square omega square. So the ratio is 5. For this question, you must be answered by integers of 4 digits in JEST exam. So the answer is 0005. Now I am coming to the alternative method. Here just you have to remember a general formula of harmonic oscillator, nothing else. Then you can solve this type of problem in a very short time. Okay, the formula is the first order energy correction of harmonic oscillator for any state due to perturbating term lambda x to the power 4 is equal to this, where x is given by this equation. If you put the value of x in this equation, then you will get a general formula which is equal to lambda h cut square by 4 m square omega square times 6 n square plus 6 n plus 3. Now to find the first order energy correction of ground state, you have to put n is equal to 0, then you will get, and to calculate the first order energy correction of the first excited state, you have to put n is equal to 1 in this formula, then you can find the ratio of these two terms, which is equal to 5. Now I am going to share a tips and tricks for upcoming examination and for any future examination. Okay, I already discussed a formula that if the perturbating term contains x to the power 4 term, then you can calculate first order energy correction of any state like ground state or first excited state or second excited state and so on. By using this formula, you have to just put the value of n is equal to 0 for ground state and for n is equal to 1 for first excited state and so on. Now if the perturbating term contains x squared term, then you can calculate first order energy correction of any state by using this formula. You have to just put the value of n only, nothing else. Now if the perturbating term contains x or x cubed term or any odd power of x term, then the energy correction of any state will be 0. If you have any other query, then feel free to write me by commenting on my video. If this video is helpful, then please share it to any physics related social media group. We will upload remaining questions by one within few hours, so stay tuned with us. Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button and click the bell icon to enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.